Genesis 1:2, it says the earth was without form and void. The word was is in the Hebrew actually means became. In other words, when Lucifer or Satan was cast out of heaven, the earth became without form and void. Darkness was then upon the face of the deep. But we won't get into that today. We have to understand who we truly are in this hour, that we can be overcomers and victorious in this hour. This generation is unique above every other generation. All past saints, all prophets looked down through time to this point, and they long to walk in this hour. I mean, it's all throughout Scripture. As was shared, you know, I've shared this many times. The saint, the patriarchs, Joseph and Abraham and Sarai, they said, no, bury us near Jerusalem. Why? Because it says, Abraham longed to see my day, Jesus said, and he saw it and was glad. So he said, oh, bury me over there. How did Abraham see his day? How did Abraham see that? Well, he had a vision. How do you have visions? In the natural, light comes and interacts with these orbs called eyeballs, which then transfers into the brain that begins to interpret and give you understanding so that you can, oh, that's what that is. All you're seeing in here, when you look at me and I look at you, is a reflection of light. That's all you are. That's all I am, is a reflection of light. So Abraham saw into the future. He saw the reflection of the light of the future. He saw that day and it registered. That's what vision is. And he said, position me there. I know what's going to happen. And so when the graves of many were opened, he was there. See, when God gives you vision, what you're seeing is an aspect of communication via light waves. Communication in the realm of the spirit is fascinating to me. Because, you know, we call it word of knowledge here. It's just instant, boom. Well, that, you know, what do you think revelation is? Revelation is an impartation of light. Ah, oh, I got it. The light went on. Somebody's finally home. We joke about that, but that's actually true. When God speaks, it's like a packet of light. If you're an IT guy, you understand this. You get packets of information. It goes boom and bursts in your spirit. And understanding comes. That's how we understand in the spirit. Light is interesting. Now, I want to give you something. Well, it says here, Matthew 5:14, you are the light of the world. Quit hiding that light. Let it out. And we were teaching this. We've been teaching this in a number of places. Started in February in Lancaster. Then we went to the Philippines. We've been a number of places, and people were taking pictures, and they said, it's crazy, but as you were teaching that message, when we took a picture of you, you're so bright, we can't even make you out. It's just light. I said, oh, that's cool. That's a confirmation. That's not about look at me. That's about look at this. His word is true. True light cannot be hidden. True light cannot be hidden. It's evident to all. Pure light has no darkness in it. That's God. Natural light can have shades or degrees of luminance, but pure light, God, has no shades. He is 100% all of that. Natural light is a function in this realm of the sun and reflections from the sun. Spiritual light is God. And we are reflections of his character, of who he is. So Matthew 5:14, we could read this way. You are the manifestation of the reflection of God who is light to this world. You are the manifestation of the reflection of God who is light to this world. You are a manifestation of the reflection of God. And you're called to be light to this world. Light is life. Ah. Where were we? Just recently, one of the places I taught this, there was a woman in there that had been under a heavy burden, a spirit of infirmity for some time, and she got the revelation, wait a minute, the light of life. That's who I am, and it flows within me. And this infirmity can't stand in the light. Boom, she was healed. In Exodus 34:29, I threw that out on purpose. Some of you need to practice that. Exodus 34:29. Now it was so when Moses came down from Mount Sinai and the two tablets of the testimony were in Moses' hand when he came down from the mountain, that Moses did not know that the skin of his face shone while he talked with him. Why? Because he was so much in the presence, the manifest presence of God who is light, that he began to naturally in his human body reflect it. You can't help it. He was irradiated. He began to glow in the dark. Literally, this is a dark fallen world. His human body was a dark fallen example of the reality that God created us to walk in. So he was glowing in the darkness because he had been in true light, pure light, God. The more time you spend in the presence of God, the more you begin to walk just like that. When I went and finally went to that conference that I had 15 whole minutes, and the first thing the Lord showed me in that vision was this. I was sitting there, this Bible was new at that time 3 years ago, and I'm thinking, okay, what's that? I never get direction this way. This is not who I am. But I threw open the Bible, and I looked down, and it was at Mark 9, the Mount of Transfiguration. And immediately the Lord said, you know, you can do this by faith. Well, isn't that how Jesus did everything? By faith? So he took Peter, James, and John up on the mountain, and by faith, he began to release that inner light, that luminous, that who he truly was. And it changed the atmosphere and it removed the veil between two realms. Y'all want visions? Y'all want to see God face to face? Release the light. That's all he did. He stepped into the fullness, or began to step into the fullness of who he truly was as a man on this earth. The Lord said, you can do this by faith anytime you want. I closed the Bible. I'm meditating on that. I'm like, okay. I said, Lord, forgive me. I need one more. I threw the Bible open again. I said, I don't do this. Timothy, I have not given you the spirit of fear, but of power and love and a sound mind. He said, this is by grace and grace alone. And I said, okay, Lord, what do you want me to share tonight? He said, just what you experienced in this time with me. I said, okay. Put the Bible away. I'm good. Don't have to come up with one point in the close. So I got to this meeting. They had congressmen and senators and mayors and, you know, they had a program. And the pastor came up during worship. He said, now, remember, you got 15 minutes. We got quite a program tonight. I said, okay, 15 minutes. And then when the worship's over, he hands me the mic. Then I time myself. I'm under authority. Okay. It took me 9 minutes. I keep reminding him he owes me 6 minutes. And in that 9 minutes, I shared about the experience and all of this. And the manifest presence of God came into that room. To everybody was standing there going, even the unsaved, the congress, you know, these people, the senator. And the pastor sneaks up and he says, whatever God tells you to do, do it. I said, I did here. And he stood there like a deer in the headlights going, okay, let's go back to the program. I went, ah. And I rebuked him afterwards. I said, when the presence of God is there, you throw that stupid program out the window. stop thwarting what God wants to do. I don't care if the president of the, who cares? The king of the universe is there. And the Lord said, see, I can do more in a minute than you could do in a lifetime. He said, now you walk in this light. Walk in this light.